Stress concentration, or often called stress risers, are locations on a body or an object due to geometric changes throughout the object or the body. For example, this bar does not have any geometric changes throughout its length. So when I pull or push or bend or torque it, it will not have stresses concentrated throughout its body. However, this bar has a hole in it where stress flow throughout the body will cause stresses to concentrate around the hole and increase the stresses where the body could fail. Or another bar. This bar has two different geometric changes along its length, where the stresses are going to concentrate here as well as here. These concentrations depend on the geometric changes, the geometric changes of the fillet or the hole, or basically in a torque situation, the fillet that exists in the bar. In order to calculate the stresses due to stress concentrations, we will look at two stresses. One stress is called sigma max, which is shown in this equation. And the other one is called sigma nominal, where sigma nominal is calculated from the geometric part of the body where the minimum area is considered when calculating that stress. So for example, nominal stress in this bar where the geometric changes are not present, the nominal area would be the area of the cross section where it is basically B multiplied by H. In this bar, however, the nominal area is the area, minimum area, going across this hole between this part and this part, above part. I have shown that in this picture here, where the nominal area considers these two areas added up in order to calculate the nominal stress. Or the nominal area, in order to consider in the stress concentration, for this case, which there is a fillet, would be this area, where is the smallest area in the body. Let's look at an example. The example that we have for you is shown on the figure over here, as well as on the board. There are two stress concentrations that will happen in this bar as we put 8 kilonewtons of force pulling this bar apart. One of them is due to the fillet, where the fillet size is 10 millimeter, as well as the size of the smallest area, which we will consider for the calculation of the nominal stress, is 20 millimeter by 5 millimeter, as it's shown in the figure below. This is 5 millimeter thickness bar. In order to calculate the maximum stress due to the stress concentration factor, which is called K, we will consider two calculations. One due to the fillet, where the fillet size is 10 millimeter. And as seen from the figure that is present over here, shows the different curve for calculation of the factor K, we will have to find the ratio of W, where is shown in this picture, in this drawing, divided by H, where is the reduced size of the bar, which comes out to be 40 millimeter divided by 20 millimeter. That number comes out to be 2. So in the figure here, we will pick W over H as 2, and then we will have to also calculate R, which is the fillet size, which is 10 millimeter, divided by the H, which is 20 millimeter, and we calculate to be 0.5. Now, combining these two and taking the graph here, where the horizontal axis represents W over H, and the different curves correspond to R over H values, if you cross these two values, if you go up and hit the right curve, which represents R over H, we will find our stress concentration factor to be 1.4. Then we will have to go back to this equation to find our maximum stress by taking 1.4 to be the stress concentration factor, 8 times 10 to the power of 3 kilonewton, which is pulling the bar apart, divided by the nominal area. As you see, the nominal area I have shown here is 20 millimeter by 5 millimeter, where it's also shown over here. This is the nominal area for the part or the fillet, considering the fillet for the stress concentration. That number comes out to be 112 megapascal. Then we would have to calculate another stress concentration where exists in this bar, and that's due to the hole. The hole, as you see, is 10 millimeters in radius, and it is cut through in a 40 millimeter width of the bar. And by looking at this figure, which shows the curve for hole stress concentration factor, we would have to calculate R over W, which R is 10 and W is 40. And that factor from this graph approximately comes out to be 2.375. Then we would proceed to calculate sigma max, where from this equation is inputting the stress concentration factor, which has been found to be 2.375, multiplied by the nominal stress. And if you look at this nominal stress, I have calculated the nominal area in the hole to be this area, where the hole is cut in the part. So this is the nominal area we would have to consider for calculating this area. And so by multiplying these numbers, maximum stress in the part becomes 190 megapascal. However, as we look at the whole picture together, our answer to consider for design or for any other purpose of presenting this bar for part of a design or a machinery, we cannot exceed 112 megapascal in the part, due to the fact that the fillet maximum stress 112. So basically, the maximum, absolute maximum between two numbers is going to be 112 for us to consider. Now, if one of these numbers exceed the maximum strength of the material, of course, would fail. But also, looking at the stress concentration factors, we look at that the fillet is 1.4, basically rises the stress by 1.4, but the hole rises by 2.375. Now it's interesting to look at the graph for the hole, where you see the stress concentration can cause the stresses to rise all the way up to 3 times the nominal stress. And if you look at it carefully, for that to happen, the hole size would be smallest possible. Rather than a big hole, a small drill through the part will make that stress concentration to be 3 times as much. So if you ignore stress concentration, you could fail a part without reaching your maximum stress due to stress concentration that you did not include in your calculation.